Every day I go online on several Facebook groups, happy lose weight fast, lose weight without being on a diet, or all these kind of groups. And if I start to filter the amount of scammers present in these groups, I see that many people just raise lots of bro science points, things that they picked up from some websites on the internet or from some magazine or some TV advertisements or programs or shows. But generally speaking, they don't know what they're talking about, and they're not necessarily reliable. Like one example is also the green tea myth that I also made a video about. I invite you to go and check it. What it means that what does it mean? It means that there are people with strong interests in selling us products, above all when it comes to food, and to create confusion, because the more confused we are, the more moldable we become. And one of the examples that I want to bring today is the coconut oil. Coconut oil, if you Google benefits of coconut oils, you will find a list of endless results of the 10 reasons why you need to eat the coconut oil, the 5 reasons why you need to eat coconut oil, whatever, how many reasons why you have to eat coconut oil because it's good for you. Now, coconut oil is 91 or 92% saturated fats, which means it's the most dense in saturated fat product that I've ever seen in my life. And they base all these benefits, all these lists of benefits, on just one single study that has been conducted in 2009 in Brazil, in which they took 40 obese women. 20 of them, they have been given soybean oil, and other 20 of them have been given coconut oil every day. Not only, but I mean, in their diet, virtually everything was identical except for the source of oil they were providing to them. And at the end of this test, the result was that the women with coconut oil had their bad low cholesterol ratio improved in favor of good cholesterol. But in reality, this doesn't mean it was because of the coconut oil. There are many other factors that we didn't control in that study, I'm sure. By the way, I give you the link down in the description, or up, I don't know where the description goes. But anyway, it's in the description. And what I mean is, what we know about saturated fat, and it's proven, is that saturated fat increase what we call bad cholesterol. They do not decrease the good one, but they increase bad cholesterol. There is also an article on my website if you want to go and have a look. I'll leave a link down here as well. So it's not possible that coconut oil would improve the ratio. And also, this ratio wasn't really that different. It was virtually identical. It was slightly better. It was so minimal that it doesn't even make any change. One true thing about consuming fat is that, yes, a diet high in fat increases consumption of fat. But that doesn't mean that coconut oil is a healthy fat. In fact, it is not. Also, if we check what kind of saturated fatty acid is made of, which is lauric acid prevalently. Lauric acid is a kind of saturated fat, is a medium chain saturated fat. I don't want to go into a too complex thing, but by the way, a medium chain saturated fat that is not absorbed by triglycerides, hence it's not very likely to be put into our fat storage, which if you think may be good, because it means, okay, I take that fat and I don't turn into body fat. But also, on the other hand, that means that it keeps in your blood vessels. And if it's not used to produce energy, it will eventually settle into your blood vessels, which is exactly what bad cholesterol does. So whenever you hear or see information on internet, it doesn't necessarily mean that it's true. I wouldn't say not to eat coconut oil anymore. I have nothing against saturated fats, but it needs to be taken in very moderation. And I mean not more than 30 grams of saturated fats per day, which basically is like if you have a spoon of coconut oil, you're nearly done it, you know? So yeah, trust nobody else than me. I'm just kidding.